So it's official. As we all know, the NBA lottery has taken place, and we pretty much know where every lottery pick will be going until draft night, where trades might take place. And right off the bat, two things are for sure. The city of Orlando could literally throw a riot right now, and no one could blame them. It'd be completely understandable. Also, Cade might as well go ahead and start looking for a place in Detroit to stay, because the chances of them passing up on him when they need a point guard is absolutely slim to none. But anyway, as the title states, today we're looking at the biggest winners and losers of this year's NBA lottery. And man, the lottery definitely didn't go as expected for a lot of teams. So this is gonna be interesting. So yeah, but I'm not trying to waste any more time. Real quick, what's up YouTube? Plug Speaks, back with a vid. If you're new, first of all, welcome. Go ahead and sub. Also, like the vid if you enjoy. I upload quality basketball content 3 to 4 times a week. And if we are trying to get to 5k subs, so I'd for sure appreciate it. But back to the vid though. Now, I'ma be alternating between the winners and the losers as I get my thoughts. So yeah, to begin, we've got a winner. And a big winner would have to be the Toronto Raptors, because they landed the 4th overall pick when they were initially expected to most likely land the 7th spot. And that is huge for this franchise, because although they won a championship literally just 2 years ago, they're already back in the stages of rebuilding, and there's been noise about their future basically all season long. From the discussions about Kyle Lowry getting traded at the deadline, all for it to not even happen, or the talks about Pascal Siakam being unhappy and annoyed with being on the bench sometimes throughout the season, and I'm sure I'm missing out on some other stuff. The Raptors really went through it all during this season, but after landing the 4th pick, they have a reason to believe they're going to be playing competitive basketball again in the very near future. Because in my personal opinion, the top 5 prospects of Cade, Jalen Green, Mobley, Suggs, and Kuminga are all capable of being huge pieces and maybe even franchise changers, maybe franchise players. So yeah, the Raptors have for sure caught a W. But now for our first loser. I mean, it's gotta be the Orlando Magic, like wow. Listen, I understand not landing the number 1 pick, but I thought they would at least land in the top 3. They fell all the way to number 5. And I know they were able to steal Chicago's 8th pick, so things aren't completely that bad, but it's definitely still a loss, and the background context makes it even worse. Because see, the Orlando Magic made their intentions clear, like crystal clear at the trade deadline, getting rid of their top 3 players, and then ending the season with the 3rd worst record in the entire league and the entire NBA. Again, not getting number 1 is completely understandable, but sheesh, number 5? Now that's just tough. And who knows, it might not matter with how talented the draft is, but for now, it's a no. Now, the next biggest winner is easily the Detroit Pistons. Now, the Pistons have literally struck the lottery by getting the number 1 pick, and Cade has not wasted any time, because news has already been reported that he doesn't intend to work out for any other team. So if you're not a Pistons fan and you're holding out hope, do yourself a favor and just forget it. Just forget it. Because there is absolutely no chance the Pistons give up the first pick unless maybe they trade for a superstar. And I mean a superstar like a Damian Lillard. So yeah, the Pistons definitely won big. Because I don't mean to sit here and count Killian Hayes out after just 1 season, but man, his first year, his rookie year, was pretty underwhelming. And Detroit brought him in with the belief that he could be a quality starting point guard. And maybe he can, but it's probably too late, because the Pistons will definitely choose Cade, and Cade is going to be running that point guard position. And we already know, Cade Cunningham will not disappoint. Like, his chances of being a bust are very low. So yeah, the Pistons, they caught a W. Now our next biggest loser is the Minnesota Timberwolves, because after striking gold with Anthony Edwards last year, the number one pick, he bought out his first season, could have got Rookie of the Year. Now the Minnesota Timberwolves do not even own a top 14 pick. And yes, yes, you heard that correctly. And it's especially tough because it's not like the Timberwolves made any big improvements this season. Because sure, their overall roster looks better compared to last year, but their actual record does not. I mean, they went 23-49 for one of the worst records in the NBA. So for them to lose their lottery pick entirely, man, it's definitely an L. And they only lost it because of their 2020 trade for D'Angelo Russell when they got rid of Andrew Wiggins. Which makes it even worse because Andrew Wiggins is flourishing in Golden State. I mean, looking back at that trade, the Warriors got him, and y'all can probably assume the next winner on the list. It's easily the Golden State Warriors. Now, the Warriors have rights to the 7th pick in the draft, and like I just went over, it's because of their 2020 trade with the Minnesota Timberwolves. And man, this gives the Warriors a whole lot of leverage and gives their fans some realistic hope at an NBA championship, because everyone should know, the Warriors' record this year is not a true indication of their ability. I mean, Klay Thompson was out for the entire year. Kelly Oubre was not able to finish the season. Steph Curry was out with a tailbone injury for a decent stretch as well. And then he was still backpacking the Warriors in the entire second half of the season. Almost won MVP, but he won the scoring title, averaging 32 points per game. So yeah, basically, like I said, the Warriors are better than their record claims. So for them to land a 7th pick, it gives them leverage, and I don't know what they plan to do with it, but the Warriors are in position to draft a really good prospect, or they could turn that pick into an all-star by trading with a team that has a player that's unhappy. So yeah, it just gives them a whole lot of options, they have leverage, and overall, the Warriors, they caught a W. But now our next biggest loser is the Chicago Bulls, because they lost their lottery pick entirely due to their trade with the Orlando Magic. And it kind of goes back to the Warriors and the Minnesota Timberwolves, because it's not like the Bulls' record drastically improved after landing Vucevic. Sure, the roster looks better. Now y'all got two All-Stars instead of one, Vucevic and LaVine. But again, the record, they ended the season going 31-41 for the 11th seed. They didn't even qualify for the play-in tournament. So yeah, maybe this trade will age well in the long run, but for now, this Vucevic trade and losing their lottery pick was definitely an L. But anyway, moving on to our last two winners, because unless I'm missing something, there are no more losers. And I'ma just combine them in one. We got the Cavaliers and the Houston Rockets. Now these two teams gotta be happy with where they landed, especially Cleveland, because they ended up higher than projected. And the Rockets, well, they got the number 2 pick. Now these two teams are both in position to draft franchise changers, because Houston may have wanted the number 1 pick for Cade, but Jalen Green is also a generational talent and could be huge for their franchise. And then Cleveland, they can finally move on from drafting guards and either pick up Evan Mobley or Jonathan Kuminga, which are two prospects with just so much talent. So yeah, both of those teams definitely caught W's. And with that being said, that's about it for this list. But I'm definitely interested in what y'all think. Did I get all of these winners right? Did I get the losers right? Did I miss out on any teams? Whether your team lost or won, how are you feeling? Because again, Orlando fans, my condolences. But yeah, I appreciate y'all watching as always. Like the sub, share, sub if new, all of that. And I'm out.